You know what has always been like a long-term goal of mine what? Is to get an apartment above a coffee shop and then develop a pulley system where I can like just lower something like with an order of coffee and then they make it and then they it goes back up to my bed and I drink it.
Wow. I think those are achievable goals.
You think so?
Yeah. You're not like making your
you
own
gotta
coffee.
Aim big.
Congratulations on Valerian. Woo! How much of it was actually real? Because it was so beautiful to watch and I was almost quite sad because I was like, oh, I guess this wasn't on
I think we were set. Real. That's it.
I think
and
we were
Clive
real.
And Clive was real. I think. I mean, I... Yeah, about... I mean, at the set, I think it was like 90% was real and the rest, yeah. 90% was real. 90% was blue screen. So 10% of it was real. Jesus. We're included in that. So it's kind of insane.
You were the 10%.
Yeah.
Is this like, I was thinking this when I was watching it. Is this like when you're a child and you want to be an actor, you're like, that's the kind of film I want to be in?
Yes.
Is that like literally what 100%, it is?
100%.
Yeah. 1,000,000%.
Yeah. Is that kind of the draw for you then when you signed on?
Well, I think also just to work with Luc Besson, like he, for both of us, I think is a hero in terms of, you know, the films he's done. Like Fifth Element was one of the first films I watched and it was introduced to sci-fi. You know, to ever thought I would be meeting him, let alone be a female hero in one of his movies is the craziest thing in the world.
How much of the stunts was you guys though? Because there's quite a lot of like jumping off of things and running into things and flying about.
Yeah, I mean, mostly.
Pretty much all of them,
it was
yeah.
mostly us. You know, I definitely, stunt guy did some of my stuff, but, you know, within reason.
He had more stunts than me. I actually think I did pretty much all of them. I don't know. Oh, no. Wait. Nope, see, just gone into a memory bank back hole. I actually think it was mostly me, yeah, because there wasn't as much as he had to do. He had a lot more.
Is there any trepidation with stunts and stuff? Because I just can't imagine throwing myself off anything or running into anything heavy.
Yeah, I have a lot of trepidation. You know, I mean, they're dangerous. They really are. I mean, being a stunt guy is it's a dangerous job, you know, and they're kind of meant to do the high risk action. And I think, you know, I had a close encounter one time where I was like demanding to do one of my own stunts and ended up being like actually kind of a scary situation. And then I learned after that, like bite the bullet, like let the stunt guy do what the stunt guy's hired for.
What was okay, it? I feel like you're trying to like teach me a lesson in that. Like, so one time.
So
Dane
DeHaan
life lesson. Died. What was it?
It was just like a scene in Chronicle. It was a really complicated sequence and I thought I was going to get to do the whole thing. And they were like, no, the stunt guy's going to get to do this part. And I... Long story short, ended up almost like getting run over by a car and like I ended up getting a camera in the back of the head and it was really intense. And then I was like, you guys were right. I should have let the stunt guy do this for sure.
See, the dangerous things and the things that get me closer to dying, I love. No, not really. But you know what I mean? It's that kind of moment where you are flung up. It's like when you are completely when you get out of your comfort zone. Like I always grew up wanting to be a stunt guy or like a daredevil, you know, Evel Knievel. So just to do any of those things, I'm really just living my childhood dream as well.
So it was based off a comic book and the comic book is called Valerian and Laureline.
Mm-hmm.
Why was Laureline kept out of the title for the film?
Generally, if you say, come see our movie, Valerian and Laureline in the City of 1,000 Planets, it's generally quite a long title. I think now for films as well, it's better to kind of keep it short, especially for things like the poster and I don't know. Of course, I think this movie is, you know, it's a two-hander. It's about their relationship. It's about their partnership. It's very much an equal thing. So, you know, that's really the main point of the movie.
Just go to bus stops and start, like, writing it in Sharpie.
Yeah, imagine. You see me at night and I'm like...
Everyone I see, I write Anne Laureline on.
Thanks, Dane.
Mm-hmm.
So, Dane, I actually chatted for you when you were in London for A Cure for Wellness.
Oh, cool.
And you said that when you were filming, you'd come to the realization that you'd never been to a club and that you were going to, like, go out with Cara and Rihanna.
Yeah.
Around the time of promo.
That's right.
Has this happened so far?
No,
we've tried.
It may happen.
Because in LA, he had to go and he ended up going to the wedding of Stevie Wonder by mistake. But so
okay, you need to like elaborate more on this.
Well, he was...
I was like, why was I not invited? Dane.
He was getting married in my hotel. So I didn't go. I didn't crash it. I had to get on a flight. But anyway, maybe soon. We might go out soon, actually. Yes. We've been talking about it.
It is the London premiere tonight.
We've been talking about it since the film. Me and we've really been trying to plan something.
But, you know, I had a really good night's sleep last night, and I'm starting to think another one might be really good.
I think once I get Dane going, once I kind of, like, handcuff myself to him, then I will be fine.
What if you're like the craziest person on night out and you just don't realize?
He is. That's what I think.
It could just be
8 o'clock in the morning. You're like, let's keep going.
you know, pent up energy that I've just been feeling. I want to release my inner party girl.
Do you have promo tomorrow?
I can't wait for that.
Do you have press tomorrow? Still, like, junket day. It's the premiere tonight, so you guys could like go crazy.
But we have to travel tomorrow.
We have to travel. Ooh, big whoop, right?
And then we have a premiere tomorrow night.
That's literally sitting down for hours,
Paris.
Though.
Yeah, like sitting down for hours. You hear that? Hours.
I'm expecting to see this in the papers tomorrow. Just you being carried out of a club. By it'll Cara be and Rihanna.
Handcuffed to him.
I wouldn't.
Him like, handcuffed
I wouldn't
to me,
rule it out.
Walking.
I wouldn't rule it out. Let's just.
Oh, London.
I'm really looking forward to this.
To let your inner party girl out.
It's good publicity, right?
Tell that to Luke.
Say that to him when you're like in a jail cell.
We'll be like Hangover. You'll have a tattoo on your face.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Yeah, you'll have no money. Your cards left.
Cool.
You'll just spend it all in the casino. I'm already writing the book. It's done.